Hey guys, so today we are going to try to understand ionic bonds. So what is an ionic bond? Ionic bond is formed by transfer of electrons. So that is the key definition of ionic bonds. Now let us see a few examples where this exactly happens. So we'll take two atoms, sodium and chlorine. Now sodium has an atomic number of 11. Now, I hope you remember how do you exactly write the electronic configuration. I hope you remember this 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s. How do you follow the trend? So you go from this slanting directions. So let's write the electronic configuration of sodium. So that can go from 1s2. We have to count that to 11, 2s2, 2p6. So that is 10, 3s. 1. Now similarly, I'm going to write the same for chlorine, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, that's 10, 3s2, 3p5, that totals 17. Now you can clearly see that sodium here has one extra, right? So if somehow sodium could lose this one and chlorine could get an extra one, both would be stable. Now, what do we mean by stable? By stable, we mean they would have acquired the nearest noble gas configuration. Now, what is the nearest noble gas configuration? So, if you remember, the nearest noble gas to sodium is neon. Now, what's the atomic number of neon? I hope you remember, that is 10, right? So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, all the orbitals completely filled. Now, just to give you a slight idea of this better, you should know that when we talk about stability, we say if the orbitals are completely filled or half filled, they are stable. That is the rule for stability, right? Now, this rule is just made easy by saying that if the noble gas, if any atom has a nearest noble gas configuration or 8 electrons in its outer orbit, then it is stable. This rule also is known as the octet rule, octet 8. So 8 in the valence shell means it has the same configuration to the nearest noble gas. Now this does not apply in the heavier elements because there you have d, f and more orbitals. Now let us look at quietly what happens if sodium were to lose an electron. So sodium right now has 11 electrons, 11 protons. Now electron means negative charge, proton means positive charge. Now if you were to remove one electron and give it to chlorine, which had 17 electrons and 17 protons, that means 17 negative charges, 17 positive charges, both the atoms were neutral, but if you were to give an extra electron from sodium to chlorine, that means now you have reduced one negative charge, right? So this 11 becomes 10, that means 10 negatives, 11 positives, so now sodium becomes plus 1 positively charged. Chlorine now has got an extra electron, right? So that 17 becomes 18. So 18 electrons. So chlorine becomes negative. Now you know the Coulomb's law. Opposites attract, right? So sodium has become an ion Na plus. Chlorine has become an ion Cl minus. And there is going to be a bond between them. A positive ion is called a cation. A negative ion is called an anion, right? So an ionic bond would be formed by attraction between the oppositely charged particles, right? So why is all of this happening? What is the energy correspondence of the whole? You have to understand that sodium had an extra electron in the 3s1, right? So if it were to leave this let this electron come out, and if the chlorine somehow could get the 3p6, right? So if it could become 3p6, and if this 3s was gone, it would become more stable. So it is better for sodium to become Na plus and has one less electron, chlorine to become Cl minus and have one more electron, and now there's a bond because they are attracted to each other because of the charge obviously, but they forms a less energy state. It's easy for this electron to live near chlorine than to sodium, and it forms a less energy state. And the energy comes from the Coulomb's law, which states that two charges, Q1 and Q2, they are the charges, separated by a distance r, which here in this case is the bond length, will be attracted to each other, and hence the energy associated would be given by the formula KQ1 Q2 by r. So this is the energy that forms the ionic bond. Now, how to represent that? It's better that we learn some Lewis dot structures as well. So this time I'm going to do it with a very different molecule, calcium chloride. Now, I've already written the electronic configuration from chlorine. So let's straight out go ahead for writing the same for calcium, which is 20. So 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2p6, that is 10, 3 is 2, that is 12, 3p6, 18, and calcium will be next, 4s2, right? Somehow, if the calcium could get off with this two electrons, it could become more stable. So the valence shell is 4, so I'm going to represent them as 4. Now let me represent the same by chlorine. So chlorine has 5, and you can see two more in the valence shell, that is 7, right? So I am going to represent it via like this, right? So if this calcium could give one electron to this, one electron to this, we can have bonds between them. Now, how am I going to represent all of this? So, I will, because when they lose electrons, they form ions, right? So, one calcium can form bond with two ions. So, I'll represent two electrons of calcium, plus I'll represent choice of chlorine and the 7 electrons, right? And then I can say that they formed ions, right? So, we write Ca2 plus, because calcium is going to lose two electrons, and then we write 2Cl, which is 2 here, 2 here, 2 here, and 1 here, and put a bracket there, right? When you represent this, you simply write CaCl2. The denominator tells you how many chlorine ions here are there. Now I want you to understand here that it's not that two chlorine atoms surround calcium ions, or when you write NaCl, it's not like one sodium pairs up with one calcium and goes there. It's formula unit. We always say it's a formula unit. That means if you take a solid sodium chloride crystal, the number of sodium ions and the number of chlorine ions there are going to be equal. It's actually one sodium is surrounded by 6 chlorine atoms and vice versa. So do not understand them to be like a molecule representing a couple of two. No, it's like when you take out and count the number of ions, there would be equal number in this case. So I hope this makes sense and you were able to understand the essentials of the ionic bond. Thank you.
Subscribe to our channel and check out other chemistry videos that we have.